Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We will start our lecture on the male genital system pathology. Start with the definition of the cryptorchidism. Cryptorchidism or undescended testis is a failure of testicular descent into the scrotum. As you know, the testis descend to the pelvis at the third gestational month of embryogenesis into the scrotum in the last 2 months of the gestation. This condition defined as failure of the testis to descend to its usual anatomical position in the scrotum at the last 2 months of gestation occur in about 1% of population, more in the right than the left, and 25% are bilateral. That to say, 1/4 of the cases associated with the bilateral right and left undescended testis. There are many theories and hypotheses regarding the etiology of the undescended testis. Some are related to the hormonal deficiency of the luteinizing hormone releasing factor, and other may relate to the mechanical effect, like the short spermatic cord and the blockage of the inguinal canal. This may be impaired the descent of the testis to its usual location in the scrotum. Sometimes intrinsic testicular abnormalities that may be related to the this failure of descent to its usual anatomical position. And the vast majority of the undescended testis are unknown. In spite of this, may be considered as a feature of some congenital syndrome, like the Prader-Willi syndrome, that may be associated with undescending testis. Regarding the morphology of testis that are not descend to its usual scrotal position, usually the testis will be atrophied, smaller than the normal size. And the higher the testis, the smaller its size. كلما كانت التستس أعلى في الانجوينال كنال في الابدومينال كافيتي كلما كان السايز مالها more smaller. Hypoplastic or atrophic germinal layer of the tubules. As you know, the tubules contain Sertoli cell and the germinal cells. Sertoli cell are supportive cell, and the germinal cell are responsible for the spermatogenesis. And so, in the undescended testis, the spermatogenesis will be affected and will be hypoplastic and atrophic, the germinal layer of the tubules. Finally, we may be end with the Sertoli only cell. ممكن تبقى فقط Sertoli cell in the tubules. Leydig cell hyperplasia. Leydig cell are the supportive cell, hormone secreting cells in the interstitial tissue between the tubules, showing the hyperplasia. Basement membrane of the tubule will be thick, and sometimes this undescended testis is considered as the risk for development of the malignancy in these germ cells. Germ cells in here, spermatogenesis may showing the neoplasia, so that intratubular germ cell neoplasia may develop and considered as the precursor for malignancy that we will talk later. راح نتكلم later on the germ tumor, and we consider this type of the malignancy as a part of the precursor for the malignancy. Undescended testis showing a lot of the complication. The first of all are infertility. The second are fourfold increased risk of testicular malignancy in the both testis, even if unilateral cryptorchidism. This mean there is increase in the fourth, يعني زيادة في risk of malignancy 4 أضعاف that the normal testis. And this increase are seen in the both testis, in spite of may be unilateral. يعني ممكن تكون testis بالright, لكن risk of malignancy ممكن يكون بالright or بالleft. This may related to the hypothesis. هذا ممكن يعني يصادق النظرية اللي تتكلم عن the intrinsic factor for the undescended testis, so that in spite of the right testis undescended, but the risk of malignancy will be bilateral. Another complication are the trauma, liability for the trauma. إذا كانت testis في inguinal canal أو في lower abdomen or the pelvis, are liable for the traumatic effect. Regarding the management, the first of all are surgical, orchiopexy. Orchiopexy هو تثبيت التستس في المكان المناسب. Orchiopexy is surgical placement of undescended testis in the scrotum before puberty. قبل البيوبرتي، قبل 10 سنوات إلى يعني 10 إلى 15% this before the maturation of the testis, because this is maybe carrying risk of malignancy. كلما كانت العملية الأوركيوبكسي earlier كلما كان risk of malignancy less. This will decrease the atrophy, that to say orchiopexy will decrease the atrophy, but does not guarantee fertility. Not guarantee fertility, that to say حتى لو رجعت التستس إلى مكانها الطبيعي ما تعطينا guarantee for fertility later on. That to say patient remain at the same increased risk for testicular cancer, and this is controversial regarding the fertility and risk of malignancy, because primarily as we talk there is a risk for development of malignancy even if undescended testis. So that the descending of the orchiopexy to the its size is not giving a guarantee for the development of the for failure of the malignancy. The location of undescended testis about 10% in the abdominal cavity, 42% in the inguinal canal, and 48% in the upper scrotum. And there is a curve regarding the percent of the germ cells with the age of the in years. That to say, in the early age, till the 5 year, there is a progressive reduction in the number of the germ cells. At the same time, there is increase in the risk of malignancy after the 5 year to the 10 year, 15 years. So that the orchiopexy should be as early as possible to be return the testis to this your position. Regarding the macroscopical picture of the testis, as we say, there is reduction in the number of the spermatogenesis. إذا ننظر هذه البكتشر اللي هي normal testis بالمقارنة مع undescended or atrophic testis. The tubule are filled with the spermatogenesis, active spermatogenesis, while on the right side the tubules are lack of the spermatogenesis and containing only the Sertoli cell. هذه Sertoli cell هي فقط ال cell المتبقية with thickening of the basement membrane, and there is Leydig cell. هذه Leydig cell ما بين the tubules are hyperplastic. Hyperplastic Leydig cell, thickening basement membrane, and Sertoli only cell, or the and the tubule are empty from the lack of the spermatogenesis in the lumen of the tubules. Other cause of testicular atrophy. Start تكلمنا ابتداء عن undescended testis, لكن هناك أسباب أخرى للأتروفي of testis, منها chronic ischemia, inflammation or trauma, hypopituitarism. That to say the cause is central related to the hormone of the pituitary. When excess of in the female sex hormone, سواء كان therapeutic, some of the disease taking for therapeutic administration, or some of condition of the cirrhosis, because the cirrhosis damaging of the liver result in the failure of metabolism of the female sex hormone. This will result in the atrophy of the testis. Malnutrition, irradiation, chemotherapy, all these are considered as the important factors for the development of the testicular atrophy. Inflammatory lesions of the testis usually involve the epididymis first, because this is the entrance of the testis from the epididymis, so that any inflammation mostly are involving the epididymis primarily. Most are sexually transmitted disease, and in addition to the non-specific epididymitis and orchitis, may be related to the secondary to the UTI, like bacterial and non-bacterial. And presented as the swelling and tenderness in the testis with acute inflammatory cell infiltration. The most common involving viral disease that affecting the testis are mumps. 20% of adult male with mumps may develop testicular involvement associated with edema and congestion in the testis, with chronic inflammatory cell infiltration mainly the lymphocyte, and may cause atrophy and sterility. As you no, the mumps may be associated with the male infertility. Tuberculosis may be involving the testis, result in the granulomatous inflammation and caseous necrosis. This is a characteristic pathognomonic feature for the tuberculosis, are the caseous necrosis. Autoimmune granulomatous orchitis can be seen in spite of its rare finding in the middle-aged man. Testicular tumor. Testicular tumors present as firm, painless enlargement of the testis. This is the main characteristic feature of the presentation of the testis, as firm, painless enlargement of the testis. The peak incidence age is between the 15 and 34 years old. 95% are germ cell tumors. Almost all are malignant. There is no benign germ cell tumor. No benign germ cell tumor. All the germ cell tumors are malignant. And germ cell tumor تمثل 95% من التستيكولار تيومر. ما تبقى من 5% من التستيكولار تيومر may related to the other type of the tumor, like the Sertoli cell, Leydig cell, stromal cell, lymphomas, and other sarcoma, and so on. Lakin 95% are germ cell tumors. Almost all are malignant. The non-germ cell tumors may synthesize hormones and result in the endocrine abnormality. That to say, not discussed extensively in this lecture, but the non-germ cell tumor, like the Leydig cell, Sertoli cell, and other cell tumor, may associated with the. So the non-germ cell tumor may presented as the hormonal manifestation elsewhere. The risk factor for testicular tumors, the first of all, are the cryptorchidism. That to say, failure of descent of testis to its usual anatomical site may give a risk for fourfold increase in the testicular malignancy. The second, testicular feminization syndrome, Klinefelter syndrome, and siblings of patients with the germ cell tumors. Cytogenetic abnormality like the age of chromosome 12, and mostly are unknown. Testicular tumors, epidemiology, most important cause of painless enlargement of testis. This is the main presentation, are painless enlargement of the testis. About 6 in the 100,000 male, more in the white than the black. Increased frequency in the siblings. Peak incidence in the 15 to the 34 years. Mostly are malignant, associated with the germ cell maldevelopment, like the cryptorchidism and testicular dysgenesis, like the Klinefelter syndrome. Testicular neoplasm pathogenesis, 95% arise from the germ cell tumor, associated with the cytogenetic abnormality, rarely arise from the Sertoli cell or Leydig cell, that's considered as the non-germ cell tumor. These are often benign. That to say, the germ cell tumor are malignant and the non-germ cell tumor are benign. Lymphoma may be seen mostly in the male after 60 years old. And this is an example for the ultrasound feature for the tumor, dimension of the mass. And this is the residual testicular parenchyma. And while this is the main mass of the tumor that are seen by the ultrasound. Regarding the classification of testicular tumors, there is WHO classification into the one histological pattern that represent about 40%. And multiple histological patterns that are represent 60% of the testicular tumors. So there are two main classifications. Either a tumor composed mainly of one pattern, can include seminoma or embryonal carcinoma, yolk sac tumor, choriocarcinoma, and teratoma. And teratoma may be mature, immature, or sometimes associated with malignancy of somatic element. All these are one histological pattern, واللي يتمثل 40% من التستيكولار جيرم سيل تيومر. الستين المتبقية are multiple histological pattern. The tumor may be composed of seminoma and embryonal carcinoma, or choriocarcinoma with yolk sac tumor, or with embryonal or seminoma, and so on. And other combination. أي combination ممكن نجده في ال multiple histological pattern of the tumors. That to say, there are two classification. Either one histology, either the tumor يتكون فقط من histology واحد هو seminoma أو embryonal carcinoma أو yolk sac tumor or choriocarcinoma or teratoma. وأحيانا الأغلب 60% يكون tumor mixture of two. ليش هذا الخليط يحصل؟ يحصل لأن يعني أصل التيومر كله سواء كان seminoma or embryonal or yolk sac or choriocarcinoma or teratoma are arise from the germ cell. هذا الجيرم سيل يحصل فيها maturation so that any stage of maturation can be giving a malignancy and can be giving this pattern of differentiation. So that when we look to this picture we see the germ cell precursor. Precursor اللي هي مصدر التيومر. This germ cell either giving seminoma or and this is named as gonadal differentiation. يعني الجيرم سيل هي تمثل أصل حياة الإمبريو حتى. فالإمبريو يعني حتى في الإمبريوجينيسيس من نشوف الإمبريوجينيسيس يتكون من جيرم سيل وسوماتيك سيل. السوماتيك اللي هي كل التيشيو بما فيها الإبيثيليال والسترومال والكل أو الجينيتيك سيل. فابتداء الجيرم سيل أيضر يحصل فيها ديفرنشيشن إلى الجونادال ديفرنشيشن أو توتيبوتنت اللي هو السوماتيك ديفرنشيشن. فالجيرم سيل كذلك ممكن تعطينا جونادال ديفرنشيشن يحصل فيها مالجنسي وبالتالي نحصل على السيمينوما or giving us totipotential. Totipotential يعني ممكن يحصل فيها differentiation to the any type of the tissue. وتعرفون هي التيشيو الأساسية اللي three main layers هي الإكتوديرم والميزوديرم والإندوديرم. This is the main tissue that can be arise in the embryo. نفس الفكرة إذا نتخيل إذا نتصور إنه الجيرم سيل الآن ممكن تعطينا نفس الكومبوننت اوف ذا امبريو اكتوديرم ميزوديرم اندوديرم وراح نشوف انه لايك ذات اوف ذا امبريو ان ذا ان ذا يوكساك انسايد ذا بروفوبلاست انسايد ذا سوماتيك اليمنت سو ذات ايذر جيرم سيل ديفرنشيشن تعطينا جونادال كومبوننت اللي هو السيمينوما اور توتي بوتنشال. ونبدا بالامبريونال. ليش امبريونال؟ امبريونال حتى في الـ في الـ في الميكس باترين راح نشوف اغلب الميكس باترين هي تحتوي على امبريونال مع نوع اخر كان يكون امبريونال كارسينوما. الامبريونال هو امبريونال من اسمها اندفرنشيتد امبريونال كارسينوما موستلي ان ذا 20 تو ذا 30 ييرز اولد. وممكن يحصل معاها سوماتيك ديفرنشيشن تعطينا تيراتوما او يحصل فيها يوكساك ديفرنشيشن تعطينا يوكساك تيومر او يحصل فيها تروفوبلاستيك ديفرنشيشن. اذا ننظر الثري مين كومبوننت اللي هو تروفوبلاست واليوكساك والسوماتيك. هذه المكونات مال الامبريو تروفوبلاست يوكساك والسوماتيك ديفرنشيشن. فكانه احنا ننظر الى الامبريو واي جزء من عنده ممكن يحصل فيه مالجنسي لان هي في الاصل جيرم سيل تشبه الى حد كبير تطور الامبريو داخل اليوترس. So that this is the main component of the tumor that to say either trophoblast. Trophoblast تعطينا choriocarcinoma واليوكساك differentiation تعطينا يوكساك tumor والسوماتيك differentiation تعطينا التيراتوما. والتيراتوما ممكن تكون mature تيراتوما. نقصد انه كل احنا نعرف التيراتوما هي mixture of the all element. ممكن نجد بها السكين والثايرويد والبرين واللانج والاني component of the mature tissue يعني تيشو تشبه الماتشور عدل تيشو نعرفها بالهيستولوجي. او ممكن تحتوي على immature tissue والimmature tissue هي التيشو اللي تشبه الفيتس تيشو اللي تشبه التيشو مع الفيتس. So that the teratoma may be immature or immature. واحيانا الماتشور ممكن تعطينا يعني thyroid tissue الموجودة بالتيراتوما ممكن تعطينا malignancy like that of the thyroid بابيلر كارسينوما فوليكولار كارسينوما ممكن تعطينا ادينو كارسينوما ممكن نجد غاستريك تيشو ممكن تعطينا ليفر تيشو ممكن تعطينا فيه تيراتوما تحتوي على اي كومبوننت اوف ذا تيشو وهذه الاي كومبوننت ممكن تعطينا مالجنسي. So that the tumor can be are differentiated from the germ cell into the somatic component or gonadal. فالجونادال تعطينا السيمينوما والسوماتيك تعطينا ابتداء اول خطوه هو الامبريونال كارسينوما وممكن يحصل بها differentiation toward other element either somatic وتكمل differentiation باتجاه التيراتوما. وهذه التيراتوما ممكن تكون mature immature and malignant component or differentiated toward yoksac differentiation وتعطينا yoksac tumor or differentiated toward trophoblastic differentiation تعطينا choriocarcinoma. So the differentiations ابتداء ممكن seminoma embryonic carcinoma, teratoma, and yoksac and choriocarcinoma. This is the main primary differentiated type of the germ cell tumor that can be seen in the germ cell component of the testicular tissue. Thank you very much.